you're going through motions. It's time to start believing the Word of God. Amen. Your talk has a whole lot to do with the blessings that come upon your life. You see, if you're always negative, complaining, down and out, backbiting, long-tonguing somebody else, you're not going to be blessed of the Lord. I don't know what's going through your mind to think that you will be. He will not bless over that. He will not give you a move every few minutes thinking, well, I'm somebody big in God's eye. I can put down my friends and neighbors and my loved ones and family and talk about people. You ain't going to get nothing from, let that man thinketh he get nothing. He will get nothing from God. You're always finding fault with people, always putting somebody down, speaking doubt and unbelief, saying one thing and doing another. Brother, there's some things that will stop the move of God in your life. I'm here to tell you, I don't care if you're the pastor. I don't care if you're a deacon. I don't care if you're a song leader. I don't care if you're the Sunday school superintendent. If you got these things in your life, the devil has got you blinded. Amen. He's got things over your eyes that you can't see the truth. Amen. I don't care if you've been to church for 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 years. If you haven't got the fullness of God and got these old things out of your life, you ain't going to be blessed of the Lord. This is right. This is true. And I'm going to stay calm this morning and explain this to you. The devil don't want you to realize this. He wants you to go through the motions. He don't care if you go to church every night of the week. He don't care how many good songs you sing. The devil cares when you come to the knowledge of the truth. He cares when you start teaching and preaching the Word of God and teaching somebody else the right of way. Amen? Your attitude, your talk, your actions speak louder than words. You know what? If I don't show love to people, if I don't show compassion to people, I don't care how many stars I've got on my chest thinking I'm somebody. Amen. In the eyes of God, I'm nobody. Amen. You got to show love to somebody. Praise God. The Bible says, be ye Christ-like. I don't care who you are. I can't imagine Jesus putting people down all the time, always finding something wrong with somebody. Oh, look at her. She's this way. Oh, look at him. He's that way. And gab, 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 gab all day long. Can't never say there's some people I've never heard them say nothing good about nobody and thinking, I am blessed. I'm really blessed. You're not blessed. You're deceived. That's right. Your emotions. People are going by emotions. Oh, when I feel good, I can dance, I can shout. But what about when the good feeling's gone? I'm back out in the world. I'm back out doing the things of the world. I'm back out doing the things that people are doing. We got to worship Him in spirit and in truth. He's God. He's God in the good times as well as the bad times. Praise God. Just because the tears can stream down your face at a snap of a finger, amen, that's not worshiping God. Worship Him from your heart. The Bible talks about how you worship Him with your lips, but your heart is far from Him. Your emotions ain't going to get it. And then you got people that bring things upon themselves by their actions and the things that they've done to other people. And then they'll stand back and start blaming God. It's all your fault, God, that I'm not blessed. Oh, if God would have just been here, this would have not happened. Sometimes you bring things upon your own self for the things that you do to others. You will reap what you sow. It's a fact of nature. It's a fact in God's word. Brother, you bad to somebody, you mean to somebody, cruel to somebody, it's coming back your way. Amen. Don't think you'll be blessed of the Lord until you repent in your heart and say, God, I realize that's been me. I've been mean. I've been cruel. I've been irritable to people. I've been talking about people. My tongue has been a flapping, putting somebody down when I should have took the time to get on my knees and start praying for somebody. Amen. Start praying for myself. Amen. Thank God. What's another thing that will... Now, this is what the devil don't want you to know. This subject this morning is the things that will stop the move of God in your life and the things that will hold back the blessings of the Lord from you. What's another thing? Sin. Sin, unforgiveness, sin will hold back the blessings in your life. There's people that's carried bitterness in their heart for years. You will not be blessed of the Lord. You will not until you get that out. Oh, mean and cruel and self-righteous is another thing that will hold back the blessings of God. If you think, well, I'm doing something good on my own. I'm number one. I'm me, 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 and I. Nobody else, just me. I'm better than somebody else. I dress better than somebody else. My clothes is going to get me through the gates. My hair is going to get me in. My actions, how many songs I sing. Nay, nay, nay. Brother, what will get you through the gates is the blood of Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. That's the only thing that will get you in. Praise God. You won't go in because your last name's Bernard or Smith or whoever you are, or Lawson like mine. Brother, it has to be a born-again experience in your life to get you through the gates of glory. But there's people that stand back. I'm better than somebody. And they'll look at somebody, old sinner over there, put them down and talk about, look at that old long-haired, hippie-looking thing. Oh, look at him. He just makes me sick to my stomach. And thinking God's going to bless you over that.